We updated the NU samples thread yesterday and today, got a little another update for it. And one of the teams we added was this Grassy Terrain team by Stories. Now, y'all know the history of Grassy Terrain on this channel. I routinely look like the worst Pokemon player of all time. Just every time I load up Grassy Terrain, it goes horribly wrong. So, of course, today, I gotta try again. I just have to. There's absolutely no other option. My opponent has already set up the Web of Truth. But you know what? We've got hope. This is so unfair. I wanted to Draco you, and instead I got goobed by Lunge. Now, what's nice, of course, is I've got this Pokemon, and what's also nice is that you can subscribe to the channel. If you'd like to support your boy, of course, I'm on my way to 10k subscribers by the end of the year. You like daily NU uploads? Get out here. They crit me with a thunder there, and oh my god, that is like actually woke turn ever. I do have foul play. I am just gonna click foul play here because I know they're shift gearing. So we get a lot of damage off there, and I'm gonna recycle. I don't know if this works how I'm hoping it works, but I want my red card back. Do I still force him out? If I die, do I force him out? I don't know. Of course not. So this is not quite going how I needed it to. I can go Thwacky, actually. This is okay. So I got the glider. So we made them Terastalize already. I got some hazards. And they let me KO the Toxtricity. So this is actually not the worst. It's not the greatest. I go Torterra here, which... I'm just gonna Woodhammer because this is under terrain. Give me my damage on you. Yeah, take this hammer. Oh my lord, Thwacky! Yo... Thwacky just put that tort in a box. That's so funny. I get free flag on. Now, you cannot give me the answers to why this is EQ, by the way, instead of earth power. It probably hits something a little harder. But yeah, terrain EQ, smile. Now you may be wondering, why did I not Draco? Well, I'm scared. They have a whole bunch of setup sweepers. So now I'm gonna get my Ori out here. I'ma start dancing. I'ma do my little dance here with this Ori Choreo. Yo, that hurt. Don't ever do that again, buddy. Don't ever do that again. I do not want to see that chip ever again. Let me quiver up more. Feels good. Now, you may think this game is over and that I've won. It's anything but over. You know... I said it was anything but over. This is explicitly why, because I knew that some goobery like this would happen. Ah, cool, I think I lose. But I'm not willing to say that I lose for sure. A U-turn there. Man, this really sucks. Like, this is really, really dumb for me. Because I would have won the game, I think, on the spot with Ori, but this mon has kind of had that history as well for me. So we're gonna try our best. I don't think I need to keep boosting. I'm just going to take my plus one. Obviously, we just got crit with Ori, so I'm not going to risk it terribly badly here. I'm just going to get rid of the Galv. And of course, people would say, well, don't keep boosting. You might get crit. Bro, they hit me twice. I might live one. I mean, I have to hope I live one, right? He doesn't have... Oh, well, he's choice banned, so I was losing always. I see. Well, actually... He's not banned, he's Scarf, but he's Reckless. That's what's going on. Ooh, hold on. I tanked one. Nah, but we still lose. Very unfortunate first game here to lose to that miss, but it just kind of is what it is, you know? It just is what it is. I think 100% of the time, we win that game without a dodge, but we'll move on now. So why am I using Oricorio though, beyond, of course, wanting to give Grassy Terrain a bit more of an attempt? Because, well, in Ditto meta, Grassy Terrain's pretty good. It's very unfortunate we ran into webs. Like, exceedingly unfortunate that it's one of the worst matchups. So why am I using this? Well, Ditto's really good. And Unburden is your best counter to Ditto. You're just looking to say, all right, how do I Ditto-proof an HO? Because that's how you want to build, of course, most hyper offenses when Ditto is like a prominent part of the metagame as well. You gotta keep that mon in mind, or else you're just gonna lose to it copying your stats. and burn doesn't get copied. So, I mean, if I have a plus two Hitmonlee, bro, I'm gonna only face Sticky Web. I don't know why I'm even trying, but can I lead with this and win? I feel like the answer is yes. I've had enough. Surely I don't lose to crits twice. Also, I probably should have Terra Ground. If that was the true misplay last game, just Terra Ground and this mon could never beat you. But as I was saying, always Volt Switch. Ew. Why do people run this? But yeah, you get your own burden, and then the Dittos can't do anything. So we got two boosts. If he goes to Reggie, I will obviously Terra immediately. Oh, this, I'm definitely Terraing. And just hoping. Yep, goodbye, Iron Thorns. You deserve a good long rest. Do I win this time? Is this win? Is this a winning angle? I want to quiver again so that I live a hit, but also, I don't want to quiver again. Terra Stellar, huh? Well, he went for Psyshock. No, don't roost, right? Yeah, roost is dumb. I'm not gonna get enough HP back. Yeah! Alright, so there we go. You saw that time, right? Like I said, I think maybe just Terra that first game, and then it's always a win once I'm at plus two. Oh, I just found something out, by the way. This didn't loop, but I actually did press for it to loop as I checked it. So this actually may just be a YouTube glitch. It's interesting. It's just so strange, though. Okay, I thought I'd gone insane with some of these videos where I'm like, I know I looped. Why isn't it doing it? You know, all that. No. It just actually is that there's a bug with YouTube sometimes not letting your video loop. Maybe. It's so weird. Anyhow, Delphox lead is quite scary. I'm gonna try paralyze it. I know, of course, you can kill me with Fire Blast, but the reality of it is I only really need rocks this game. And I just want to make sure this mon isn't going to be a huge threat later on. So they got an Ori. They've decided they want to win, which is pretty fair. This is, you know, pretty fair. The problem here is, what do I even go to, right? Because I don't want to lose my terrain immediately unless I think I can just sweep. So I'm a U-turn. And this actually ends up working out pretty decently for me because now I get to go Grafaii. Hopefully they're not Terra Steel. But if they are, Hitmonlee technically could beat them. Alright, well we get some justice there. As I finally get a little bit of good luck in this video. I go Luke here. I'm just gonna low kick you. Yeah, give me my damage. Fortunately, I'm just really glad that their guy did not try and own my life. I think if they with Ori forced it a little harder versus Thwacky, maybe. I don't know though. This comes out now. Acelerock definitely KOs me, so I'm actually just gonna go Hitmonlee. Because I know they're Acelerocking. I'm not convinced that basically what I'm CCing there for is because I'm not convinced that this mon wasn't just going to KO me with CC. They went for it. So this is a little bit easier of a play to make. And they still have to care about my CCs. Can I get greedy here? I don't think I get one shot. Blaze kick! Yes! I got to blaze kick something. This move never does anything for me. Then I just get to easily clean. Look at that. Easy clean. Easy, clean CC here. Beautiful. Beautiful game. Beautiful, beautiful game. Also, I'm playing at low ladder right now because I am working on a bit of a schedule crunch. We had the AC people over all day today, trying to fix our air conditioning unit. Or not fix, replace our air conditioning unit. And so I don't have as much time before I head to work. So, y'all get some of this. Okay. I was trying to check this just to see, like, it still says it's on loop. And y'all even saw it. Wasn't it, like, literally set to be looping before I even did any of this? I don't know. I'm T-waving this dog, though. Even if they're just, like, lead stealth rock stuff, it's useful. As they do set up their hazard there. I'm actually gonna foul play to break Sash here. Also get a huge hit. Ooh, wait, I can just foul play and get a KO then. I'll take that. No! Why'd you Acelerock? Oh well. Get some chip on Raikou. I can recycle that back if I really need to. But I want to get some spikes now. This mon, I swear, This is the latter's favorite Pokemon, low-key Toxtricity. They think it looks so much cooler than regular Toxtricity. They think it just has more swag, infinite swag, endless swag. And so they run this man with Trailblaze. As they said, you need shift gear, bro. I just need the speed. I need one speed boost. Disregard the fact that my Toxtricity will still be outsped by the entire tier. It's not important right now. Also, I'm just obviously always T-waving this too. This is like the least helpful sequence my opponent could take. I'm actually just gonna foul play this. You're gonna Celerock me for like 20 again. And they get fully paralyzed, so that's unfortunate. They don't get the chip. At the end of the day, it's like I know what line I'm taking in this game, and it really didn't matter if that happened. So this comes out. I know he's gonna start boosting with Trailblaze. I am just gonna foul play. If he as he overdrives. Huh. Scarf? I guess I can get another spike. I think he has to be Scarf, right? I'm gonna go Flag on here and set up my rocks. Little unfortunate they've got the Screamer here who's just like ready to check. No, he's not. What? Hyper Voice! Now wait just a burger flipping minute. Also, I should obviously EQ here, right? Just take the free Q chip. This could be Scarf. It really doesn't matter if it is. I'm just looking for my Thwacky to come out next turn. Yeah. I needed the free switch. Keeping Flygon is, of course, though, useful, because this could be Choiced Raikou, I guess. There's nothing stopping it from having a like Scarf or something. As my opponent disconnects there, pretty nice. I'll turn that down just a little bit. I feel like it was maybe coming loud. So as you see, it's set to loop. So, as we wait for our opponent to come back, let's just see, am I truly delusional? Because the last one was set to loop. I'm pretty sure this one was set to loop as well before it even came on. That looped properly. There you go. Let's start looking for another battle. Because I don't think this guy's coming back. If he does, I should be able to put him in a box pretty easily at this point. I don't believe he can stop my setup sweepers. Like Grafaii especially. Look at this. Look at my Grafaii and then look at the rest of his team, right? There's nothing really here that's going to be able to stop it. So, should be a clean one, but I'll pause while we get the next battle as well. We'll be right back. All right, last guy never came back. Now we've got Pachirisu 2024. So I guess that's their preferred presidential candidate. Pretty fair. This is a kind of an annoying lead just because they're as the Espeon, but I like Flygon versus pretty much anything on their team. And this actually works out fine, because now I just get... I gotta be careful. Let me go Incin here. What? Incin. Let's get something to go Flygon. Man, this is a ladder Incineroar. I am so mad. This is ladder Incineroar. You're supposed to have zero speed. It's how all of you work. You know why also this game's terrible? Because there's Quag. I'm gonna go into my Grafaii now. This thing's max speed and has Will-O-Wisp, guys. I think I just uninstall my internet browser. Please hit. I know I could just Terra Blast Grass. I want this Quagsire coming out thinking it's a check. Man, that's so sad. I have to Terra there just now to kill that. If I had gunked, I would have hit two. I will always Terra Blast Grass here. Yeah, I don't care, noob. I don't care, noob. GG. GG fraud. Axiomon's like gonna beat me now. It's so funny. So as you see, this is the problem. Because I missed, we're in a horrible spot now. They good play there. I'm not worried about this mon. It does not beat me. But because I missed the Tenta, I couldn't beat it. This guy's got Morning Sun, Bulky, Calm Mind. This is a really annoying set. This is also just a loss, like guaranteed loss. But yeah, if I'd hit Gunk, I would have two-shot that, and then they would have gone Quag. And it would have been Oval. So, as you can see, that's where sometimes those misses really do hurt you. Because there was actually, incentive to preserving the lure. Now, there's just nothing I can do. I don't want a Fire Blast, I want Rocks. But we'll still try to play it out. Maybe there's some weird win condition still that I haven't spotted. I just don't think I can set up and beat their team. Oh god, not when I'm taking that much from knockoff, bro. Not when I'm taking that much from knockoff. This comes out. I mean, I literally just have to try to quiver. I forgot. Dude, what the hell? This guy said, I've lost to Porygon one too many times. You know what? GG, bro. GG. I know that that gunk shot miscost me, but GG. That is an insane tech. His team had a lot of good countermeasures for what I brought. Not only the bulky Espeon, so like, he's still traded fine versus it. It's just, I'm pretty much denied from the spiking that game. I got lucky to ever get one lair. And then he had the mirror. That's just tragic, man. That's just tragic. Some matchups are always going to be rough. Flygon lead this game looks pretty good. I don't see what they lead into me where I'm like truly upset. Well, they led this mon, so I'm going to go for Draco. Hope I hit. Please, right here. Don't get the 10 ran right here. Right here. One might say that this just looks like it wants to be hit. We get a Drake off. Bro, I'm going keys. I'm not going to make this more calm. I was going to say I could go Grafai. Not Grafai. I was going to say I could go into my Thwacky predicting the Shell Smash. It's not worth it. I have red card. I got a spike here for free now. They're going to be forced out after like tapping me once. And if this thing Terras, then I have Thwacky to revenge kill it. Like, you know, you weigh your options here. And I don't really think that we're in a spot where we need to care about that kind of soul read turn one. Especially given this is the only mod that could even set hazards. And we have run into a Focus Sash Cloyster before from lead. And yeah, it didn't really fear. It didn't really like scare me. Really lame that it works like this, by the way. I did not know that's how red card worked. I thought it would activate in the first hit, but it seems like we're okay. Yeah, though. I wasn't willing to get spiked up on for free like that. I mean, I guess it would have. Who cares, man? I'm not willing to let them Icicle Spear is the true reality of it. They Terra here. I do get a T-Wave, so that's good. I live that. I'm gonna go for Foul Play here. And if you are locked into Psycho Cut, yeah, I was gonna say, you can just drop Glade. So it turns out Klefki is the star of the show. We did get our Oricorio Super Sweep game 2, and we had potential angle for it game 1. I'm gonna take another spike here. I literally revenge kill this with Thwacky. So I don't need to worry. I don't even have to go Thwacky here if I don't want. I could go Flygon and just Quake. Nah, let's go Thwacky and just Glide, because this helps me set up to actually get my Seed activated on one of these dudes. Which is a little bit more important at this point than any other tomfoolery that I was considering. Did you sack the Cloyster there? Probably could have gone into one of these dudes. Or like Arcanine or Dragalge, I should say. But this is fine too. Just gonna look for the super ownage. Come on, I dare you. Go into Arcanine, bro. I triple dog dare you, man. I triple dog dare you. Go Arcanine, man. You think I won't bring out the Flygon? There's no way you're not timid. There's absolutely no shot. You're not Scarf Dragalge. You're not timid. No. No. I don't even need to look at my screen. I know this turn is going exactly how I want it to go. Yep, you turned. Thank God. Now we'll sack Flygon. Flygon, you've done your job. Oh, he specs. Interesting. I will now. You know what? No, give me my damn rocks. Give me my damn stealth rock. Yeah, give me them rockers. I'm gonna throw off a fire blast on the Bone. If he suckers, that's fine. I don't need to preserve this. I'm just looking for basically a free pivot. He can't Terra anything at this point. So, yeah. Going to Lee. Hit him with a CC. If close combat from Hitmonlee does not pack this Bonnet's lunch very neatly and kindly, then there's a problem with Hitmonlee that we may need to discuss a little bit more in depth. Just maybe. Just maybe, you know? Come on. Come on, Irish. What you got? What you got for a well-played Hitmonlee, brother? You got nothing for it. That's what. Ka-chow. We do kill the Bone. Arcanine is still a bit of a threat. Now, the funny thing is I'm Terra Fire. So, like, technically, there's a route where I go for my Terra or something, and he's not just e-speeding me for a two-shot. I don't know if we live in that world. But I could look for it. He goes kill a Watcherl here. I'm gonna just go for my knock. 63. I could dodge. Never mind. I could not dodge. In fact, there was not a chance to dodge. This man saw the future. He said, you know what I need here? An air slash. We're just gonna hope that the pom-pom beats him, which I think it does. Only annoying thing is, I bet a hurricane on this. While also dodging crits. So, we'll try it. I think we should be safe, but sometimes you're not as safe as you think. Yeah, Revenant's up. If he stays in, I don't know what he's staying in to do other than T-Bolt. Hey man, I clicked the wrong move there. I meant to click Quiver Dance because I always have it in the first slot. And I accidentally clicked Revelation Dance instead. Thank God that this dude didn't spam Thunderbolt this whole time. That would have been doing a lot more damage than Air Slash there. He would have two-shot me with T-Bolt. Yo, that would have been really bad. I actually would have lost. Outright, I would have lost. So thankfully, my opponent did not want to hit me with that. I'm not even gonna, like, complicate this. I'm just gonna Terra and go for Rev Dance. Hurricane definitely kills Dragalge from here. But this lands always, so I feel a little safer going for it. Thoughts? Questions, comments, concerns? No? Okay, good. They go back out to Pillow, and then they forfeit. Nice! The funniest thing, if they were, like, wind power Kilowattrel, that Rev Dance turn one would have actually been useful, because it would have killed them. Oh, that's so funny. Pom Pom Puree. Why this guy got a real team? Are you a real person? Huh, interesting. Hazards look okay this game. I don't want to play it though. I do like Hitmonlee actually a lot. Hitmonlee is low key, I think, how I win. I need chip on Dragalge, but if I Terra Fire, I don't worry about this thing burning me at all. Which I kind of like. I'm gonna leave keys here because I've got useful T waves for a lot of these dudes. And they have a shout. I will literally T-Wave you immediately. You think I won't? You think I won't paralyze this massive threat alert, Mon? You're off your rocker if you think I won't. You're off your rocker, Pom Pom Puree. This guy's name is actually kind of insulting as well. Hey, you think I won't do that though, brother? I will always go for that greedy T-Wave. Yeah. I was gonna say, and then I'm gonna yum this too. He did not yum though. Oh, time to U-turn. I got my one spike. My one spike. It's all I wanted. Just one. Go Talon. I dare you to go Talonflame, brother. I triple dog dare. Yeah, that's what I thought. Going to you. He specs. Getting my rocks up. Specs because he took spikes. That's literally how I know. This is a V. Come on. I was going to say I'm going to pivot here. I'm actually not going to pivot there. Going to you, and then I'm a U-turn and get Flygon back out. Baba Booey. Now the question is, who do I want to go to? I've decided it's you. I've decided Hitmonlee is here. I'm Terra Firing immediately. I will be pressing the Terra Fire button immediately. Yeah. Yeah, what you trying to do, Dragalge? Don't you dare. Bro, what? Oh my god, he's a jetpack? Wow, I thought he'd be specs. Also, he's like a jetpack defensive. Right? That's defensive Dragalge with a jetpack. That's very strange. I get my terrain buff. Give me a little bit more HP back. There's no way you live this. Nah, get out. Get off my screen, Talonflame. Guys, there's a problem with this Hitmonlee. It's defective. It doesn't kill anything. This Hitmonlee is very defective. It killed nothing, dude! What? Is this mon just worse than I thought? Dude, I think I lost. I'm trying to dedicate to going for the game there. I have to knock this. Aw, that dude actually outplayed me so hard there. Unfortunately for them, I am a little bit better at Pokemon. Come on, man. Okay, I hit that one. I'm gonna roost up always here. Come on, Oricorio. Come on. Dude, come on! Like, what is this bullshit? Ah, it's so sad, man. Of course, though. I get it. I understand. Yeah, I mean, that's just... What can you do? Oricorio? Every time we use a... Oh, come on. Another Espeon Quack! Why am I facing this? Every time. Yo, maybe this game, Grafaia, I can actually get the lure to work. I swear, dude, every time we use this bond, it always is getting crit. Even back to the Joey video we did, where it was, there was a Quiver Ori on that team as well. The highlight of that live was, of course, the guy predicting our Terra with the thorns and smoking us. But, dude, every time this bond gets crit, we had a very... Maybe I needed to attack there. I should have read a quick calc just to see if plus two killed, but I had no faith that it did. I don't think Ori killed. I'm lead flag on it. Looks like an okay enough lead. I'm gonna try to set rocks here. If he gives me them, great. If he doesn't, that's fine. My opponent gave me rocks. I will not be taking my earthquake here. Actually, Drake, surely you don't stay in. Well, I mean, that's just kind of insulting at this point. That's just kind of insulting, is it not? I mean, come on, man. I'll Drake again. I don't think he goes for a dragon move here. If I get hit by Dragon Claw. Alright, buddy. Alright. Alright. I see where this live is going. Okay. Well, can I hit Fire Blast? Maybe I can hit a Fire Blast. Like, I generally think that Pokemon is a fun game, but this battle is certainly testing what it means to be a Pokemon player. The Terra to get rid of that is so good, though. I'm, like, super excited. I genuinely don't care if this is Specs. Yeah, get out. I knew this boy wasn't Specs. I had a feeling. I had a feeling that tonight was going to be a good night. Okay, you ready to hit this Gunk Shot? Come on, Monkey Door. You're not Monkey Door, you're Grafaia. Come on, Grafaia, hit this Gunk Shot. Alright, well, you know what they say. I mean, I'm going to forfeit. Normally, I don't forfeit games. That is genuinely just not winnable. That many misses, you can't win. Move on. I think 99% of the time, you win that battle. But those misses are really... The miss on Flygon, actually, I don't think even mattered that much. Because it led to us getting the... The Alolan Sandslash to Terra. But missing on Espeon is just kind of cringe. And again, no, I'm not going to Terra Blast Grass immediately. That's a dumb play. It's really bad. Because you don't want to reveal the tech. This team's main way of beating Quag is supposed to be that you catch him off guard. Like, I think otherwise you genuinely can't. But what have we learned? Well, as you can see, we're a 4-4. So, not exactly the best showing of grassy terrain. I'd like to believe that, three of these games were very winnable. I think the two Oricorio Pom Pom crit games, I think those were very winnable. I think without the crit, the teams that we were facing would have lost. Even with me over-dedicating to Hitmonlee mistakenly, because, look, I mean, I just expected Dragalge not to die. I want to run that Calc as well. Was he just straight up, like, defensive pack on Dragalge? Because I think that's a really weird set. It worked out really well, but, like, I wouldn't run that ever, right? I don't think he was actually even full defensive. Didn't we do... We did like 70-something, right? Actually, no. I think he was. Because Dragalge ate it. He was already weakened from, hazards. He was just straight up defensive with a Jig. That is a whack set. Nah. You're not running Sticky Web Quagsire. Hello? Dude, these people are testing everything about my patience. Yeah, I think both those games were winnable. I think last game was winnable. Well, I'm gonna get all my damn spikes up. And you can't fucking stop me. Now I'm gonna go Thwacky. I'm gonna knock here. Yeah, this thing Terra's, I honestly think it might be worse for me, which is really funny. I get a crit. I mean, that's a really good crit. What can I say? That's a really good crit. He goes out to this. It's not scarf or specs boots. I can go Flygon. I'm a Draco here as he stays in. Very interesting play. I don't know what I want to go to. Maybe this. I'm a Quiver, I guess. The problem is this mon, dude. I think I have to like double switch here or something back. Cause I have to save my Terra for this. I have to pop it with Terra Boss Grass. He stays in to attack again, so he just doesn't care about his Typh dying for some reason. Very suspicious battling. I'll rock up though for sure. It'll cancel out Xiao regen, which is useful. He goes muck. Hey, tell me that you have Shadow Sneak without telling me that you have Shadow Sneak, you know? Oh, he doesn't have it. Interesting. Well, I will be going Grafaii now. And I'll be pretending like I beat you. This is a bad play, by the way. Actually, maybe it's okay. I'm just still so slow, dude. Like, all this Sticky Web stuff has been really bad to run into. Which, it's in new ladder, so you see Sticky Web more than any other archetype when you're laddering here. It's just like... I don't think I could beat this. That low kick did so much. I'm dedicating my Terra, though, to get rid of that. I don't know, I feel like Xiao's still gonna beat me. Yo, I got some good luck. Let's go. Alright, so that's it. Obviously, incredible dodge. Yep, I would forfeit too. That dodge cost you the entire game. I can't front. But, admittedly, my ability to feel bad for people is pretty low right now. This last guy. I've got 3 wins stolen. Stolen! So, keep going. I mean, God. Imagine, by the way, if it was grassy terrain. This is how you could tell the difference in viability between these HO archetypes. People like grassy terrain. I think it's kind of I think it's viable. We have a sample for it. This is literally a sample team. Yeah, it just always feels so inconsistent when I use it. Maybe I'm just bad at using terrain. I can't disregard that as a potential option. Speaking of terrain, that one guy that's been commenting for like 2 weeks now asking about electric terrain, he's gonna be so heated when he sees grassy terrain loaded. And I'm ready for it. I am ready for it. We'll get one more game. Where what? That means that we're... Yo, I'm getting my damn revenge. I'm getting my damn revenge on this goblin. You think he Terra's turn one? I think he does. I think this guy Terra's turn one. He did not... He saw me use Fire Blast on him, and then he said, you know what? I'm gonna stay in. This man is insane. You've got a problem. You have a mental disorder. Oh my god, not the freaking Espeon already, T-Wave pairing. No. Oh, the foul play did a lot. So this one's not a bulky Espeon, which is good to see. Oh, cool. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna spike. No, let's let that KO itself. So now we're gonna go back to Flygon. Do you think our opponent... Oh, yo, I'm gonna set rocks again. I'm gonna set rocks again. I knew it. I'm gonna Drake again immediately too. Please, go Flygon like you did last time. Well, he didn't, but I mean, is this even bad for me? This guy is annoying me. This guy is really annoying. Oh god, I gave this terrain? There's just no way, dude. I gave this terrain? And he just stays in. He doesn't care. This guy is a madman. Is he sub as well? I guarantee you he's sub. We're about to see substitute come out from this. I just know. I just know how these dudes think. I'm in their head. So we're gonna switch into this now. I'm gonna just take my knock here. If they go into Quagsire, that is okay. That's such a funny turn. There's no reason to Swords Dance. Just go for your knocks. So this dies now to rocks. So he may try and spin. Okay, sacked. That's good. I'd like spikes up just for Quag, frankly, because as you saw, low kick from Grafaii actually does a pretty good amount. It just, they could Terra Poison the next turn so easily that it doesn't really matter. The amount of Quag we've seen, though, this video is kind of disturbing. I'm pressing close con- yeah. What in the hell, dude? Respect your damn Sand Slash! Don't just let it die! You just let me pop it in the mouth! You are a terrible trainer, BRC20! Have some empathy. Not empathy. Empathy's not- I don't think either empathy or sympathy is what I mean. Have some damn morals! I'm gonna knock this. You can liquidate whatever you want, man. I really don't care. I'm going Flygon here. I'm just gonna spam Draco and see if I can crit. Alright, well, I could not crit. I'm now gonna disrespectfully Terra Blast Grass with Grafaii. You think they'll predict this? Guys, I just want to say that I'm so sorry for everything that I've ever done in life. Bro. Of course he U-turned immediately. Why would he not? I should have probably just stayed in. In my defense, there is no defense. I'm staying into Woodhammer, by the way. I literally have to. If this thing sets up, I super lose. I might super lose no matter what, admittedly. But I'd at least like to go down swinging. He's Focus Blast, guys. Lord help me. Except there is no helping me. You dare a ghost? He might be. You'd be terrified. Maybe they'll go hard Quagsire here. Hard into Quag, and then I think I can KO you. Brother, I'm at my wit's end. I'm at my wit's end. Terra Fly. Dude. I'm trying. I'm really trying. People have said they don't like when I point out luck. I'm trying, man. But like, come on. You see all of this whole video. I mean, let me. Now, it's actually not the end of the game. It actually is. I forgot I had to use Seed on Hitmonlee earlier. Maybe I'm faster. It is kind of wild, though, to get lucked by the same dude twice. I think it's funny, but it's pretty wild. All right, you know what? One more. Surely. Now, I want to end it on, like, a cleanish game. Just one cleanish game. I don't care that I'm facing Lapras, bro. I want a game where it doesn't feel like either I won because I lucked a guy into oblivion, but I also don't want to end on a loss where it's like, you know, there's that idea of the self-satisfaction that you want really badly. If you're Scarf Man, you're Scarf. I can't even fight back against that. I'm just going to assume that I would live a hit anyway. If this agility's up, though, I think I punch my monitor and then leave. All right. So, Calm Mind Gallade is a very, very good set. My opponent is simply inventing the metagame as we know it. Simply redefining the metagame and what it means to use Gallade. Because, you know, why would you want to use Sharpness Gallade with its incredibly high attack stat and powerful cutting moves when you could instead use Calm Mind and get absolutely nothing out of Gallade that you would otherwise. Yeah, I'm just gonna Drake the Lapras here. I do connect. Good, good, good. I'm gonna go Thwack. Yeah, I had a feeling this was gonna do that. I'm gonna now double to Klefki just in case this thing Terras. Just in case. Now, if it Terra grounds, there was... I mean, at that point, come on, many Terra grounded. We get keys in. I'm out. I'm gonna T-Wave. Actually, nah, I'm gonna set Spikes. Brother, stop. Stop that. Stop. Stop, stop, stop. I don't wanna see that. I'll eat that. Unfortunately, I'm red card. Ooh, wait, very fortunately I'm red card. Very fortunately I'm red card and I drew out the Charizard. The Belly Drum Charizard, okay. All right. I get a para, okay. I'll just take my KO, I guess. Yeah, there we go. I hope y'all enjoyed this live. Did not go how it needed to go. So every time I use Grassy Terrain, I'm like, oh, this time I'll give it another try. Surely it never goes well. My success rate using this archetype has got to be below 50%. I can't imagine that I have a positive win record with Grassy Terrain. It just does not add up. Not over all the video. You know what? If someone wants to, look up my channel. look at all the grassy terrain videos I've done. What's my overall win loss? Because it's gotta be. I don't think I have more wins than I do losses. But I hope y'all enjoyed, even though these games didn't go very well. It was still pretty fun. And I mean, we did get one. Oricorio could have 3 Super Smashes, but alas. I still think Hitmonlee deserved that one win. It's just, yeah, I mean, what can I do against defensive eject pack Dracalgy? You know, that I got goobed. I saw no lefties, no boots. Thought he'd be offensive with specs. He just wasn't. Thanks for watching, though. Catch y'all next time. Peace.